भगवते वासुदेवाय
ओम नमो 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 भगवते वासुदेवाय
सदृशो अस्ति
शिवा
शिवा
पंथा
पंथा
योगिना
योगिना
ब्रह्मसिद्धये
ब्रह्मसिद्धये
नयुज्यमानाय
ब्रह्मसिद्धये ब्रह्मसिद्धये ब्रह्मा
नयुज्यमानाय भक्त्या
नयुज्यमानाय भक्त्या
भगवत्यखिलात्मनि
भगवत्यखिलात्मनि
सदृशोऽस्ति शिवाक्पन्ता
सदृशोऽस्ति शिवाक्पन्ता
सदृशोऽस्ति शिवाक्पन्ता
सदृशोऽस्ति शिवाक्पन्ता
योगिनां ब्रह्मसिद्धये
योगिनां ब्रह्मसिद्धये
नयुज्यमानया भक्त्या
नयुज्यमानया भक्त्या
भगवत्यखिलात्मनि
भगवत्यखिलात्मनि
सदृशोऽस्ति शिवाक्पन्था
सदृशोऽस्ति शिवाक्पन्था
योगिनां ब्रह्मसिद्धये
योगिनां ब्रह्मसिद्धये
Perfection and self-realization cannot be attained by any kind of yogi unless he engages in devotional service to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, because that is the only auspicious path.
Najjamanaya bhaktya bhagavat akhilatmani sadisosti shiva panthya yoginam brahmasiddhaya. Yogi means connecting. And Brahmasiddhaya means self-realization. Aham Brahmasmi. Simply to know that I am spirit soul is not sufficient. It must be further advanced. Then it will be siddha, perfection. Brahma siddhaya. To realize I am Brahma, aham brahmasmi, that is not sufficient. You have to make further progress. Just like to become feverless. Suppose one is suffering from fever. So medicine is given and the no more fever stop. That is not sufficient. Not only fever should stop, but you should get strength, you should get appetite, you should have normal life. Then it is perfect cure of the disease. Similarly, Brahmasiddhaya, to realize that I am spirit soul is not sufficient. You have to be engaged in the spiritual activities. That is bhakti. Bhakti means spiritual activities. There is activity, it is not. The Mayavadi philosopher, they think that stop material activities. Brahma, Satya, Jagat, Mitha. Why you are engaged? The Buddhist philosophy also, they say Nirman. Stop this material life. The Buddhist philosopher, they do not give more information. We are suffering on account of this material combination. That is their philosophy. Because this body is nothing but combination of earth, water, fire, air, mind, intelligence, and ego. So if you separate it, let the earth go to the earth, let water go to the water, let fire go to the fire, then you become zero. If you dismantle, just like we dismantle some house, so there are so many things coming out. So let the doors be taken, somebody, windows, somebody, the bricks, somebody, and rubbish, somebody, then there is no house, zero. This is called Nibbana theory. No more existence. We are suffering pains and pleasure. Pains, there is no pleasure. Pleasure means accepting another type of pain. I am suffering just like there is boil on your body, it is suffering, and to cure it, another suffering, surgical operation. So it is going on like that. Actually, there is no pleasure, there is only pain. So the Buddhist theory is to dismantle this construction, and then there is no more sense of pain. The Mayavadi theory also like that. Their activities, because they are material activities, therefore there are sufferings. So the material activities, they are false. You simply understand yourself that you are Brahma and no more activities, stop all activities, Brahma realization. Their example is given that if you take an empty pitcher and you put into the water, so long it is not filled up, there will be some sound, bud 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 bud. And as soon as the pitcher is fully filled up, there is no more sound. So all these Vedic mantra and other, they're only means. So when one is completely Brahma realizes, then there is no more chanting, hearing, or Vedic hymns. Everything stop. The same theory, Buddhist theory and Mahabharata theory, is almost practically the same. They are saying, make it zero, and they are saying it is mitha, false, stop it. Brahma-satya-jagan. Brahma-satya means Brahma realization, I am Brahma. I am the same, supreme, so on. But that will not help you. That is simply theoretical. Practical is Vaktya Bhagavati Akhilatmani. Vaktya Bhagavati Akhilatmani. Bhagavan is everywhere. Ishavasamidam Sadbam. Ekappasau Rachayatam Jagadanna Koti. जत शक्ति रस्ति जगदन्न चया जदंतं अन्नांतरस्थं परमान चयांतरस्थं गोविंदमादि पुरुषं तमाहं भजन अखिला हरि ईश्वर भगवान अखिलात्मनि अखिलात्मनि भक्ति भक्ति दिस वर्ड इज एप्लीकेबल only to the Supreme Personality of God. Therefore it is said here, Bhagavati Akhilatmani. Bhagavan is not alone, is not only localized. He is everywhere. Andantarasthang paramana chara chara chantarasthang. Goloko eva nivasati akhilatma bhuto. That is called akhilat. Although he has got a particular place, just like Krishna, he is here. He is in many other temples also. That is Krishna. It is not that Krishna, because he is in one place, he cannot be in other place. Just like we are. We are conditioned. We are here. I am sitting here. You are sitting here. But you are not at your home, in your apartment. Krishna is not like that. Krishna, goloka eva nivasati akhila atma bhuto. He is always in the Golok Vrindavan. Still, he is annantarastham paramanuchayantarastham govindam adipurusham tamangmaya. Annantarastham means he is within this universe. This universe, the whole universe, is going on because there is the Garbhodakshai Vishnu. Ekapasau rachayatam jagadanda koti. There are not only one anywhere, that koti, millions, and ekangshi nasthito jagat, one ansa of Krishna, that Garbhodakshai Vishnu, is there. Just like this body is working nicely because the soul, the spirit soul, is within this body. Similarly, the whole universe, its activities are going nicely, regularly, everything, because the Garbhodakshai Vishnu is there. It is not difficult. Matter cannot work so nicely. Don't think that so many planets, they are floating in the air without any arrangement. There is arrangement. Annantarasthanga paramana chayantarasthanga vishtabhya aham idam sadmam ekangsthina sito jagat. Therefore, Krishna is there, akhilatma. Krishna is super soul. Ishara sarvabhutanam riddhesha arjuna tishtat. Krishna, although localized, although he is always in his Golok Vrindavan dham, still he is everywhere. Therefore his name is akhilatma. Hari Ishara, Bhagavan, akhilatma, Parameshwar, Paramatma. There are so many names. So here it is said, Najujjamanaya bhaktya bhagavati akhilatmani. If you engage yourself in devotional service to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is super soul or expanded everywhere, even in the atom, then your yoga system for Brahma Siddha, for self-realization, will not be complete. Siddha, jata tamapi siddhyana, Garbhati said, manushyanam sahasresu kaschit jatati siddha. This siddha. Siddhaya means Brahma Siddhaya. Out of many millions and millions of persons, one is interested in Brahma Siddhaya. Nobody is interested. We are crying everywhere please come, we have made this center, please come and realize yourself and make your life perfect. But nobody is interested. Manushyanam sahasyasu, therefore Krishna said, out of millions and millions of persons, one may be interested. Similarly, there is a statement in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, Eirupe brahmanna bhrumite kono bhagavan jeev guru krishna kripaya paya bhakti lata bij. Kono bhagavan jeev, to come to Krishna consciousness is not very easy. It is meant for the most fortunate person. Kono bhagavan jeev. Bhakti jo, to accept Krishna consciousness or bhakti jo, is not so easy. Therefore, general people, they are not interested. General people, they are not interested. Bhogai sajja prasaktanam taya apurita chitasam. Vyavasatmika buddhi samadhau na adhigacchati. Those who are too much materially interested, sense gratification, they are not very much interested in Krishna consciousness. They are not very much interested. So don't be disappointed that many people are not coming. It is a subject matter which is not for many people, only select. Just like if you inquire how many fools are there, you will find practically everyone is fool. But if you want to see how many MAs are there, it will be very difficult to find out. So it is by Krishna's, Lord Chaitanya's mercy that we are preaching Krishna consciousness all over the world, and the fortunate, those who are very, very fortunate, they are coming to it. But otherwise, it is not very easy thing that people are interested in Brahma Siddha. Brahma Siddha means complete self-realization, a perfect self-realization. That is called Brahma Siddha. To understand, first of all, Brahma, Jnana Vairagya Yuktena, that is also Bhakti Yuktena. In previous verse, we have discussed that Jnana Vairagya Yuktena, Bhakti Yuktena, ca atmana paripashyati udasinam prakritim ca hatojasam. To be less influenced by the material modes of life, one has to come to this platform of jnana, vairagya and bhakti. Otherwise it is not possible. And that the same process being stressed again. Najajjamanaya bhaktya bhagavati bhakti, where it is to be applied. Somebody said, I have got bhakti. Where you have got bhakti? Now I have got very much bhakti to my wife. I love him. I love her very much. I take care of her. If I do not see her, I become mad. So this kind of bhakti is not explained here. I have got bhakti for my family, I have got bhakti for my country, I have got bhakti for Goddess Durga, I have got bhakti for so many demigods. No, that kind of bhakti will not do. Therefore it is particularly said, bhakta bhagavati. Bhagavati, and to the Supreme. What kind of Bhagavan? Nowadays there are so many Bhagavan. No, not that kind of imitation Bhagavan. But what kind of? Akhila Atmani. You ask this so-called imitation Bhagavan, are you Akhila Atman? Are you present in everyone's heart? Can you say what I am thinking now? So Bhagavan means he must be Akhila Atman. Don't be misled by so-called Bhagavan. Everything is there. Bhagavan means Akhila Atman. He knows. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Ishvara sarva bhutanam riddhese. If you are Ishvara, then you must be present in everyone's heart. Sarvasya chaham riddhisannivishtya. Ishvara, Krishna is Ishvara. Therefore he said, sarvasya chaham riddhisannivishtya. I am staying in everyone's heart. So if you are Ishvara, if you are Bhagavan, are you staying in my heart? Do you know what I'm thinking now? So, Akhila Atmani. Everything should be very scrutinizedly studied. Bhakti is only for Bhagavan. Not that my bhakti for this or that, for this demigod, for that demigod, for my family, for my country, for my society, for my wife, for my cat, for my dog. This is not bhakti. They are imitation. That is lust, that is desire, that is not bhakti. Bhakti means Bhagavati. Bhagavati means Akhila Atmani. So if we can develop that Krishna consciousness, bhakti, then our life, successful life, Brahma Siddha, complete self-realization will be possible. Therefore it is said, Sadrisha Asti Shiva Pantha. No. There is no other alternative. If you Brahma Siddha, Brahma Parabrahma is Krishna. Brahma Siddha means to understand what is the relationship. I am Brahma. That's all right. Aham Brahmasmi. But what is your relation with the Parabrahma? That is Brahma Siddhi. Brahma and Parabrahma, there are two Brahmas. Why there is Atma and Paramatma, Ishvara and Parameshvara. So, living being and the supreme being, Nitya Nityana, Chetana Chetanana. These are the Vedic information. There are two, always two. Atma, Paramatma. Brahma, Parabrahma. So, and Brahma Siddha means not only to understand that I am Brahma, but I must understand what is my relationship with Parabrahma. That is Brahma Siddha. That means we must know what is Parabrahma. That Parabrahma is Krishna. Parabrahma param dhamam pavittam paramam bhava. Purusam shasatam dibbam. We must know what is my relationship. That relationship is already explained. That I am qualitatively one. Brahma and Parabrahma means both of them one in the platform of being Brahma. But Parabrahma is very, very great and I am simply Brahma, small. And the Vedic instruction is not Ahang Parabrahma, never said it. Ahang Brahma, that is all right. But you cannot say I am Parabrahma. Nobody says. There is no such maxim in the Vedic literature. Parabrahma is one, Kaivalya. Kaivalya means there is no alternative, there is no duplicate, there is no equal, there is no greater than. That is Kaivalya. So nobody can be equal to Parabrahma. anubhavi can be greater than Parabrahma. That is Parabrahma. So, Brahma Siddhaya means simply one should not understand that I am Brahma, but he must understand what is relationship with the Parabrahma. That is Brahma Siddhi. So, for Brahma Siddhi, for self-realization, people are trying in so many ways. First of all, the business of human life is only meant for this purpose, Brahma Siddhaya. So long we are, athato Brahma Jignasa. This is the Vedanta Sutra. Brahma, because unless you become inquisitive, then how there can be Brahma Siddhi? Therefore, this human life is meant for Brahma Jignasa, not that simply whole day work. They are also inquiring. They go to the market. What is the price? What is the rate? The whole day. In share market you go, kya bhav hai? But everyone is asking. Not for that kind of question. That everyone is questioning. From the morning, what is today's news? Immediately newspaper. What is the news? Then it is no more. Then you go to the market. What is the price of rice? What is the price of this? What is the price of that? You purchase. Then you eat. Then you go to the office or market. Then again, what is the price? What is the... Not that kind of inquiry. That is going on. That is also going on by the cats and dogs. They are also inquiring. Where is food? Where is remnants of foods, where they are thrown out, so that I can go, I can take. The crows are also doing that, that kind of question. You should not waste your time like the cats and dogs and crows by inquiring, where is food, where is food, where is food. Food is there for you, fixed up. Don't bother. The Bhagavad says there, tashaiva hi ta prajati ta kovida. Nalabhate jad brahmatam uparjata. Now, not only in cats and dogs' life, even in heavenly life and other life, we are simply inquiring, where is my sense gratification, where is my sense gratification? That kind of inquiry will not help you. Tasyaiva hi ta prajati ta. You should inquire for something which you never did before. That is Brahma Jignasa, athāta Brahma Jignasa. What I am? I am thinking I am this body and I am engaged, but actually I do not get any pleasure, any happiness. When I get information that when you will be realized, self-realized, Brahma Bhuta Prasannātmā, when you will be self-realized, Brahma-realized, then you will be prasannātmā. Jasmin vijñāte sarvamedam vijñātam bhavanti janglabdhyā chāparanglābhaṁ mannate nādhikaṁ tataha. These are the śāstric injunctions. So, this life is meant for Brahma-jignāsa. This life, this human life is meant for Brahma-jignāsa. Ādhar-jignāsa, inquiries, that is in the cats and dogs and hawks and crows and everywhere. So, don't be bothering. If I don't bother, then how shall I eat? That people generally say, that everyone becomes Krishna conscious, how we shall eat, how things will go. Now we are Krishna conscious, practical example. Are you not eating? Are you not sleeping? What business is stopped? We have no business. We simply beg. There is no certainty that tomorrow I shall go there, I'll get this money. There is no certainty. We do not know. We are eating in the morning. We do not know whether there will be food in the evening. If Krishna gives, then we can eat. You know it very well. We have no business. We are not professional men. We are not going to the market. for what is bhav, kya bhav hai? No. So are you not eating? We are eating, not only eating, we have got 102 branches, and every branch there are at least 100 men. They're all eating. Why? Because we know Krishna will give us. Krishna giving food to the ants, to the elephant. Why not to his servant? We have no. If you have got this confidence, then the Shastra says, "Tasyaiva heto prajati tokovida." You should simply try for perfection of life, brahma jigyasa, athata brahma jigyasa, janmadasya. This is the only jivasya tattva jigyasa. This is the only business. What I am? The answer is aham brahma. So aham, I am the same brahma. So then what is my relation with the param brahma? Jigyasu seva uttamam. Now, when there is question of jigyasa, brahma jigyasa, then we inquire from a person who knows. Therefore it is said that tasmad gurum prabaddeta jigyasu shreya uttamam. If you are actually interested in inquiring about Brahma, then you must go to Guru who knows Brahma. Tasmat gurum prapaddeta. You cannot understand Brahma realization alone. Therefore, according to Vaishnava philosophy, adau gurbhasram, the first business is to take shelter of a bona fide spiritual master. If you want, not only brahma jigyasa, any, you must go to the perfect person who knows things. If you are wandering on some street you do not know, you ask somebody, where shall I go, in this way or that way? So this is natural. So about brahma jigyasa. Brahma jigyasa means that is not ordinary jigyasa. It is called uttamam. Uttamam means transcendental to this material world which is full of darkness, ignorance. That is called udgata tvamam jasmat iti uttamam. There is no more darkness, simply light. If you, at night, you inquire about something, then it is very difficult. But if you go in the daytime, and at night if you got up on your roof and want to see where is Bombay or where is Santa Cruz, it is very difficult. But daytime you can see. Similarly, uttamam. You must go out of this darkness, come to the light, and then you will see. So that light is given by Guru. Ajñānati mirandhasya jñānānjana salākaya. That light is given not by bringing one torch light, but jñānānjana salākaya. The light of knowledge. The light of jñānānjana salākaya. Chakshur unumilitam jina tasmai si gurave. Guru's business is to give you light by knowledge. Then you understand. Tasmad gurum prapaddeta jigyasu sri uttamam. How the gyan, knowledge, light is given? Shabdi parecha nishnatam. Brahmani upasamasrayam. This is the Guru's system, Guru's symptom. What is Guru? Sabdi parecha nishnatam. He has completely assimilated the Vedic essence of life. That is called Guru. And what is Shabda Shastra or Vedas? Shruti Shastra. Shruti means Veda, knowledge. Veda means knowledge. Knowledge is received through ear, by hearing. That is real knowledge. Not by experimental knowledge. You cannot understand which is beyond your sense perception. by experiment. Just like you cannot understand who is your father by experimental knowledge. Let me make experiment and find out who is my father. That is not possible. Because it is beyond your experience. Your father was existing when you are not existing. Then how you can understand by experimental knowledge? The authority is mother. Therefore, Vedic knowledge is the mother. The Puranas are the sisters. They are explained like that. You should understand from the Vedas what is the ultimate knowledge. And Krishna says, Vedashta sarvai ahameva vedna. The ultimate knowable objective is Krishna. So simply by understanding Krishna, jasmin vijnate sarvamedam vijnatam bhavanti. If you can simply understand Krishna, then you understand everything. You haven't got to understand separately Krishna's enlightenment. Tesam aham. What is that word? Samudhritya. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Tesam evanu kampartham. अहम अज्ञान जंगतम नाशयामी आत्मभावस्त ज्ञानदीपेन भास. इफ यू एक्चुअली कम इन कॉन्ट्रैक्ट विथ कृष्णा एंड कृष्णा इज विद इन योर हार्ट. कृष्णा इज नॉट फार अवे. कृष्णा इज एवरीवेयर बट इज स्टिल नियरर. ही इज विद इन योर हार्ट. ईश्वर सर. सो इफ यू बिकम अटैच टू कृष्णा एंड कृष्णा सीज now you are attached to Krishna, then riddhantastha avadrani vidhunati suhitsata. He is friend of the devotees. He is friend of everyone, but a special friend of the devotees. Suhitsata. Therefore, you have to become a devotee. Therefore, it is said, najajjamanaya bhaktya. Bhaktya means devotee. Who performs devotional service unless he is a devotee? Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, bhaktyamama vijanat. So, if we become devotee, if we take to devotional service, then Krishna says, tesam aham anukampartham, for special favor. Special favor. What is that? तेषाम एवाहम अनुकंपार्थम अहम अज्ञानजं तमो नाशयामि. कृष्ण सेज आई किल ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ इग्नोरेंस. सो सिंपली दिस क्वालिफिकेशन रिक्वायर्ड दैट यू बिकम परफेक्ट डिवोटी ऑफ कृष्ण. देन यू परफेक्टली बिकम ज्ञानी. ज्ञान इज देयर. सिंपली इट इज कवर्ड बाय द कर्टेन ऑफ इग्नोरेंस. Just like in darkness, everything is there. The light is there, everything is there. But as soon as it's dark, we cannot see where the things are there. So, Krishna says that anyone can understand himself, anyone can understand Krishna and the relationship, provided the darkness of ignorance is taken away. That is required. That is done by Krishna personally. For whom? Tisham Ivanukampa, Tisham Satatajuktanang, Bhajatang, Pritipurbaka. Those who are engaged 24 hours with love and faith in devotional service. Tisham Satatajuktanang, Bhajatang, Pritipurbakam, Dadami Buddhi Jugam Tam. Buddhi Jugam, he directs, do like this, do like that. Then, what for buddhi? Jenavam upajantite. Then gradually you come to Krishna, back to home, back to garden. Therefore it is recommended here, najajjamanaya bhaktya bhagavati akhilatmane sadishosti shiva pantha. Shiva means auspicious. Shiva means auspicious. So if you actually interested for self-realization, if you want to become perfect in this life, Shiva Pantha, the most auspicious, most perfect Pantha is, what is that? Na bhaktya, Bhagavati. You just become a devotee and engage yourself in devotional service to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, not the so-called rascal Bhagavan, but Bhagavati Okhilatman. That Bhagavan who is present everywhere. That Bhagavan. Not this false Bhagavan. Okhilatmani. These are the shastric injunction. So, that Bhagavan, no, I don't find that Bhagavan. No, that Bhagavan is within your heart. Ishara sarva bhutanam, that is real Bhagavan. So, as tene brahmarida adhikabhai, that Bhagavan is always active. He instructed Brahma. Brahma, the Lord of the universe, he got instruction from Krishna and he created the whole universe. And what to speak of you? He'll also give instruction to you, provided you take to the devotional service, bhaktya, bhaktam.